Take one of Halloween special.
You gotta insert the spooky music and stuff.
Okay.
Ooh.
Okay. Ooh. All right. Welcome back to HM and Big E. Today we are talking, this is going to be our Halloween special.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to talk about kind of horror films that we liked or left a big impression on us. And yeah, this will be our Halloween special. We thought we'd get into the spirit.
Are you a horror guy? You don't really look like a horror guy.
I take offense to that. How dare you, sir? No, I don't watch a lot of horror. And so actually the three movies that I'm going to bring up are kind of movies that, horror movies that I watched probably well before I should have, and that were, like, that scarred me. Like, I was scared for a long time. So I don't know. What are you guys talking about? What are you bringing to the table? What are the three the ideas?
I'm not a guy that is into gory horror. I think that's not that interesting.
Okay.
I like good stories, good directing, good acting. It's like the same with all the movies that I watch. So okay. As long as it has that, if it has a little bit of horror element,
okay. Suspense,
I'm okay. You know, horror is a big, expansive genre too, because you got science fiction horror.
Yes.
You got, you know, ghost horror. You got gory. You know, it's so expansive.
Yeah.
So it's kind of almost hard to.
Yeah, yeah.
What's your top five, top ten?
It's hard. That's kind of so. Rob, how are you approaching this?
Well, horror contest. Films is actually what we grew up with as kids. When we visit family in Montreal, what we would do is, you know, during the summertime, we play outside, and then at nighttime, we just put on a horror flick. So we've watched all the Friday the 13th, all the Nightmare on Elm Street, and we also saw, you know, a lot of 80s and 90s.
All right, so like maybe Rob is our resident horror expert. Why don't you kick us off, Rob? What's the first movie you're bringing to the table? Okay. Are you recommending it, or what, give us some context here.
So when we decided this, I figured I'd decide on or choose the three most kind of like impactful to me.
Yeah.
Overall, that's spookiness and good quality.
Sure.
And the first one I want to bring to the table is Event Horizon.
Oh.
Yes, by Paul W.S. Anderson.
Okay.
And pretty much it's a film that is more science fiction-y.
Yeah.
Has Lawrence Fishburne, Sam Neill, and Jason Isaac, who played Lorca in Star Trek Discovery.
Okay.
This film, again, this is one where it's like, it was really spooky. It's pretty much The Shining meets Hellraiser in space.
Okay. Yeah, the premise, I haven't seen it. The premise is they travel and then they basically end up in hell or something, right?
Yeah, so pretty much the premise is, you know, you want to travel. They had this engine that goes, you know, faster than light.
Sure.
You know, they end up in another dimension that is sort of hellish.
I see. Is it kind of like, because, I mean, there's different horror, right? There's different scary. There's like jump scares. There's kind of unsettling.
There is one scene in this movie I remember watching. It is scary.
Okay.
It's gory. It's nasty.
Okay.
That's all I remember about this movie. But
the
mere mention of this movie, I remember that
scene.
Yeah. But again, it's one of those films where it's, you have a crew, you know, trying to, so Event Horizon comes back. And then, you know, there's a crew that goes to try to salvage it, right? And it's one of those films where you're kind of figuring out, who's going to
die
and who's going to remain. So that's another thing I like.
Event Horizon. Thank you, Rob. Homie, what's your first movie that you're bringing to this discussion of horror, Halloween special?
You got to bring in a classic, 1975's Jaws.
Ah, yes.
And this is probably, it does make some horror lists, you know, but it's just one of the, you know, top 50 films of all time. Spielberg at his best. And literally from start to finish, it's a good movie. The acting's good. The editing's amazing. There's not a wasted scene. And why it's a horror movie to me is, I remember watching it as a kid, probably 5-6 years old, watching on TV, and I didn't want to swim after.
Yes. And actually, so I'm going to switch my orders around because my second movie is very related to that. Before I saw the movie Jaws, which I didn't do until a little later, I went to Universal Studios and went on the Jaws ride.
Yes.
And that, again, as a young kid, very scary. And so same thing, didn't really want to swim. But so this is related to that. Another ride that I believe no longer exists at Universal in Orlando. It's something like behind the thing of her and like of how they kind of go into how, you know, these special effects are made.
Yep.
And there's one scene, I don't know if you remember, where they go and it's the Bates Hotel. And it's the psycho scene where it's the shower and they kind of recreate it. They get a volunteer to recreate it. Oh. And then they show it. I remember seeing that. I forgive my parents. They probably never seen the movie. They didn't know what it was about. But I mean, I was probably like 6 or 7 as a psycho. And honestly, for probably about a month after that, I would shower with the shower curtains like open, like half looking at the door. So Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho, even though I haven't seen the whole movie, just that one scene, which is, I mean, it's an iconic, iconic scene. And he's a masterful director, and there's so many like specific cuts and angles. I think it's one of the shots that have like, I think 40 something cuts in like, you know, 30 seconds or something. Like, it's crazy. But the suspense, the music, everything, very, very creepy, very impactful, scarred me for at least a month.
Yeah. I mean, Jaws is going to be a classic on everybody's list forever.
Yeah.
So what's there to say about it? You know, if you haven't seen it, you definitely need to watch this movie.
The music adds so much.
Oh yeah,
to Jaws. I think that's so. Da-da. Yeah,
just two notes.
Was it just the two notes?
Was it John Williams?
I believe it was John Williams.
And it intensifies.
And
most of the movie, actually, the genius of Spielberg is you don't see the shark at all. You only see him at the very end. He's like this massive shark, but you're just scared.
Oh, we remember the famous quote. We're going to
need a bigger boat. Yeah, there's a lot of quotes.
All right, back to you, Rob. Second movie you're bringing to our Halloween special.
So second movie I'm going to bring is a different type of genre. It's actually based on a Japanese film called Ringu, which is called 2002's adaptation The Ring.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
And for me, this film was... It mastered the jump scares. Because you know, a lot of the Japanese horror films, it's all about the jump scares. This one, they did a really good job bringing it over to the West, like, you know, the adaptation. And for this film, I mean, the whole premise is you watch a video and you get cursed and you pretty much die in 7 days, right? And Naomi Watts, her goal was to try and, you know, save herself as well as her, I think, ex-husband and her son, and trying to, you know, solve the mystery to remove the curse.
Right.
So, you know, again, when you talk about the soundtrack, the soundtrack was done by Hans Zimmer for The Ring. And I remember that because the music was, the score, amazing. And it did add to the film. Like, you have to have good sound and good music
in order
for a horror film to be.
I remember watching this, and all the rage of those in those days was getting together for a party or something. And because it was, what do you call that? It was like, they would show that you're watching The Ring, you might die. You know, you had that feeling, and people were kind of, it was, what do you call that? Immersive experience or something. Mm-hmm. But I know Japanese horror is another video because it's a different kind of thing altogether.
Second movie coming?
I'm going to go with The Witch.
Oh, okay.
The Witch, Robert Eggers. And he also did The Lighthouse.
Yes.
And recently, The Northman, which is not as much of a horror movie, but I'm going to pick him because he's sort of an upcoming director, and I think he's mastered sort of folktale kind of horror. Mm. The Witch is really about...
Anya Taylor-Joy, right?
Yes, and it was kind of her breakout role, and I'm sure the movie was made with almost no money. Yeah. It's just in New England folklore about... Right. A witch haunting this one family and cursing this one family. And it's not a lot of gore at all. You don't see a lot, but you see the after effects when it happens. And is she dreaming or is she not? Mm. And it's all about manipulation. And it's done well. I think it clocks in at like 92 minutes or something. Yeah. Very short. Yeah. So it's very precise. Yeah. And I'm looking forward to more of what Robert Eggers does. But I would say on the modern side, The Witch is good.
Excellent. So I'm trailing back from modern, going back to the early 90s.
Yeah.
Again, I was a young immigrant boy, and I was 6 years old. And my aunt, I don't know if you remember, but my aunt, she was really into renting movies from Blockbuster.
Sure.
And so as a 6-year-old, she thought it would be appropriate to show me Child's Play 2.
Oh, yes. But, you know, is that really scary?
I was so terrified. I was terrified for years. years.
Okay.
I was so totally scarred by this movie. I still, I mean, it's on my list. You know, one day I'm going to go back and watch it.
Why not Child Play 1, though?
Because I didn't watch
it. Oh, she just rented.
She just rented. I don't know if she saw
it. She probably thought it was a Disney movie. It's a cute boat, little doll.
Yeah.
Child's Play.
But it's about the soul of a serial killer is into a doll. And the doll goes on a killer rampage.
I just didn't understand this movie, though. I always thought, why don't you just take a baseball bat at this thing?
Yeah, I know. Or just kick it.
Kick him.
I know. Now, as an adult, as a rational adult, I can see that.
Yeah.
But as a young child that had a lot of stuffed animals and dolls and then toys and stuff, that freaked me out so much. It was so inappropriate to show that to a six-year-old. Yeah. That's my second contribution. Not a good movie. Not a great movie. Cinematic masterpiece or anything, but really, really impactful, scarring for my childhood.
But it did spawn off other,
films, it's an entire franchise now, right?
Yeah, I mean, the 80s had a lot of these kind of goofy stuff, like Gremlins, and it was the pinnacle of, practical effects in horror movies, and Child's Play is definitely one, and it's still referenced to this day. People will still dress up and wear clothing like that during Halloween.
Chucky. Terrifying.
Terrifying.
Final movie for our Halloween special.
So, final movie. Again, I'm going chronological order.
Yes.
2013's The Conjuring.
Ooh.
Starring Patrick Wilson and Vera.
Who's in Moonfall.
Patrick
Wilson.
Directed by James Wan.
Okay.
Who did Furious 7, which is, my favorite.
Aquaman.
And Aquaman. Two massive blockbusters.
Indeed.
Yes. Conjuring. It's come up with a few sequels.
Also a franchise.
Yeah.
So the reason why this one stands out to me is because it's based on true events.
Yes.
So I thought that was very interesting, and I think James Wan, he actually does a really good job with the jump scares, but more importantly, building up to it. So rather than just have something just like come out at you and it's like spook you, the tension is built up and you actually feel it in the movie. So I think The Conjuring essentially evolves the horror genre for me.
Okay.
So that's why I have that on.
Yeah, a lot of horror, isn't so much about the actual scare. It's that buildup. It's that tension. It's that expectation of it, that anticipation that's almost equally as important. So, all right, The Conjuring. What's your final contribution to our Halloween special? Horror movies.
There's so many. I thought about doing Saw.
I thought one of you were going to mention that. That's why I didn't put that on my list.
It's just Saw's good, but the next six Saws are just so bad. But the first one is a very honorable mention.
Yeah.
I thought about doing Terminator, but that's very into much science fiction.
Okay.
So I will probably have to go with Silence of the Lambs. Another big Oscar winner.
Yes.
This is not just a horror movie, but it's obviously
psychological
horror. It has a lot of, the acting obviously phenomenal. Mm-hmm. The direction is also really good. Soundtrack. Everything about this movie works. And so I'm picking a lot of the Oscar winners.
Yeah.
But obviously Anthony Hopkins is a standout star.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So scary in this role. And and it's just, what can you not, anything bad to say about this movie? Not really, but it sort of defined, suspense horror for me. I think it was out in the 90s, and I watched it as a teenager, and it was just like...
Yeah, I watched it as a young kid, too. Again, my aunt renting these movies.
Yeah, this movie's about butterflies. Yeah.
Silence of the Lamb. Great choice.
Great movie.
Great choice. My final one sort of touches into kind of you sort of mentioned into the genres, but it's an important one for me is the original Alien.
Oh yeah. That's obviously going to be on
the original Alien. For a couple of reasons. I mean, I remember watching it as a kid and, it's a really good movie. And it's like, this is kind of boring. And then, halfway through it, it completely changes. Yeah. And then, that tension just kind of never lets up. So that's really, really good for that reason. And obviously, the directing and the acting, all of it is really, really
great.
That's
a game changer.
Yeah, total game changer. But personally for me, I think that's one of my first, sci-fi movies.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I watched it before I watched Star Wars, before I got into Star Trek.
Yeah.
Like, any of these big franchises, I was like, wow, it's amazing. And then, so I watched Aliens 2. Oh, so good! Yeah. Aliens 3.
Alien Resurrection.
But this was back then, so Predator. Predator. Oh, Predator's good too. Oh, Predator 2. Oh, so you know, it was a bit of a roller coaster. But this was the this I attribute to this film the start of my sci-fi, my love of sci-fi. And so it definitely has horror elements. It's just shot really, really well. And Ellen Ripley, iconic, you know, character and the direction. Everything's really good about this movie.
I don't know if any of these lists though really hit the horror that most people think
of
horror.
I know,
Friday 13th, Nightmare on Elm Street, you know.
I know, but again, I don't watch a lot of horror. It's the stuff in the 90s, you know. They say Scream was supposed to be a big game changer. I'm not sure why. I remember watching that. It was kind of, you know, Final Destination. I don't know if you count stuff like that. I know what you did last summer. That's the kind of light horror.
Did anybody even mention Halloween, Michael Myers? Halloween Ends just came out. and he actually, I think he finally dies. After 40 years, they die, and they make sure they show him dying.
Yeah.
Was Jamie Lee Curtis in that one?
Yeah.
She's
back.
Sure,
she's back.
Sure.
Her final appearance as a character after 40 years. So, but I'm surprised none of you guys mentioned, especially the horror expert.
Exactly. Yeah.
Did you like those movies?
Well, I mean, like, yes, I did grow up with them, but they were, again, for us as kids, we were just films that we laughed at, right? It wasn't like scary. Well, I mean, it was scary, but like compared to the three I brought up, these three actually gave me nightmares.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, for Jason, Nightmare on Elm Street, The Blob, I don't know if you guys watch Blob.
No.
You know, these films are just films that we just laughed, right?
A lot of lists will place the movie The Thing.
Yes.
There, you know, on top horror lists. Obviously, The Shining.
The Shining,
you know, Psycho, like you said. So there's a lot of movies that we probably definitely missed. But these were probably movies that you watched as a kid and it scared you, or it changed the way you watched movies.
Yeah, so I guess this ends up being a bit more of a personal list. You're kind of like, you get to know, maybe we're sharing kind of who we are, getting to know each other a little bit better. So, I mean, what do you think about our choices? Let us know kind of what has been impactful for you. What are your kind of top horror movies? Maybe not just kind of Oscar winners like The Lazy Route, but just kind of like what really scared you growing up and what scares you now kind of watching. Maybe he doesn't get scared and he just wants prestige movies. So let us know in the comments below. We'd love to chat with you. But until next time, keep spookily watching things.
And please subscribe.
Like
and subscribe to this channel.
Thank you so much.